here from VMware, and I'm here with Ophir Abikasis, who is the CEO of TeraSky. And what Ophir is going to do today is he's going to share with us two of the practices that he has built around VMware's cloud offerings. The first of those is what he calls real business continuity, and the second of those is the area of application development. And the interesting thing, I think, you'll find is the revolutionary aspect of what he's delivered. They could not have been delivered before. So I'll let you hear more. So, Ophir, first of all, then, what do you mean by real business continuity?
Hello, everyone. Hi, Chris. Yes, as you know, people often use backup, disaster recovery, and business continuity interchangeably, but they are very different. Backup obviously involves making a copy of the data, but if an airplane, for example, crashed into the data center, it would take many months in order to rebuild the entire applications and the infrastructure that customer had. The company would stop working for months. So people do disaster recovery for application and copying the data to remote sites using products like VMware SRM, Zerto, and other products. The problem with that is that you need to copy the entire infrastructure, which is obviously too expensive in most of the cases. So people try to map their application and to prioritize them. So what we see with customers that they take the tier one application and deploying a disaster recovery solution for them. That sounds good in most of the times, and CIOs feel comfortable with that because then they can say to the organization that they have a DR solution. But the reality is changed. The reality is different. Because we see that customers moving the tier one application, and they suddenly realize that they need to get many of the data from the tier two, tier three, and tier four application. So once again, we are in the same situation. We need to run a full disaster recovery solution for the entire environment, which costs a lot of money. So that brings me to what I call real business continuity. So here we are using VMware VCDR and VMC on AWS cloud products. VCDR use AWS S3 storage, which is relatively a low price storage, instead of VMware, and present this as a local storage for the VMC nodes. So what we have already delivered to the customer is this. We replicate all the data from all applications to the AWS S3 storage. We replicate all the VMs into small footprints of VMC on AWS. So then we have all VMC, all the VMs are allocated to the VMC cluster that we have. When there is a disaster, all we have to do is to expand the number of VMC on AWS nodes. Then we have all the data on the AWS side. We have all the VMs working, and the entire replica of the entire workloads of the customers are in the cloud. Customers then buy only what the resources that they need at the beginning, and in case of disaster, they are paying for the full footprint. Because of the cloud, I think that this is the first time real business continuity is a reality for our customers. And we see that as amazing. We have great examples of customers that already deployed similar solutions with VMware Cloud on AWS and VCDR.
Ophir, this is really remarkable what you've just outlined here, because really what you have said is that in the whole history of computing, there has never been a genuine business continuity solution available until now. And that reason is because backup basically just covers the data, and you'd have to rebuild the infrastructure. And disaster recovery would mean having a replica of your environment, which is too expensive. So people have only ever done disaster recovery for a very small number of applications. And those applications would not last long because they would need to be fed by tier two and tier three applications. So what you have is you have all the data in S3, you have all the VMs copied but squashed together in a tiny footprint, and you just need to expand that footprint when you have a disaster. And this solution, I think, really will only work if your client believes that the cloud provider will have sufficient nodes in the event of a disaster. And they will believe that of Amazon, that they would have 20, 30, 50, 100 spare nodes available when they need it. They would not believe that of anyone else. And, you know, if I was a marketing person up here, I would come up with a slogan, something along the lines of, you can do genuine business continuity for not much more than paying for backup, because people could back up in S3. So genuinely, that probably is the case. So something like that. But anyway, that's just a thought. Okay, that's fantastic. That is revolutionary up here. Let's go into the second area that you're interested in, application development. Most people think of something exotic with application development. They think of, you know, developing on native, cloud native. They think of containers, Kubernetes, and so on. That is an area of interest for you, and we will talk about it. But there's a kind of halfway house which you want to emphasize first. So tell us more, Ophir.
That's right, Chris. You know, in spite of all the excitement around developing in the cloud, most of the applications are still running on-premise for customers and primarily on VMware. We see customers trying to rewrite those applications, but we see many, many projects as well failing because it takes too much time to do so, and the risk is very high for our customers. So what we offer to our customers in some of the cases is to try to utilize the advantages of running the application in the cloud. And since, as I mentioned, most of the application I'm running on VMware, we are able to move them to VMware-based hyperscalers and to get all the capabilities and all the benefits that public clouds can offer. And I can give you an example for that. We have a customer, one of the biggest gambling companies in the world, that built their services on-premise in the data centers. I can tell you that 10 years ago, when we needed to estimate the required resources in the data center, we just calculated the size and the throughput and the performance required, and we added like 20 to 30%. This is something that we cannot do today because everything is changing. Everything is instant with those applications and online gaming. The customers of those applications needs to get fast, reliable, and instant responses from the application. So it's very difficult to analyze, and it's very difficult to provide the services on demand. So what we did with this customer, we took all the application servers that providing those services for the end customers, and we moved them to VMware Cloud on AWS. We did not touch all the database layer, the networking. We did not get into any complicated deployment within the application itself, but only the application layer moved to VMware Cloud on AWS. It is the same VMware that they have on-premise, so we did not have to rewrite anything in the application itself. What is the end result? The customer gets the application, lives on public cloud, able to provide unlimited resources to unlimited customers. Everything happened immediately with zero risk. This is a huge success for this specific customers. Then we see, you know, we definitely see that connected, and we see huge impact on the business where they can run much more versions of the applications. They can attract much more customers, which is a great success for them.
Ophir, this is really, really exciting what you have said. So just to recap, you have a client who has huge peaks and troughs in his demand. And it's the peaks and troughs are unpredictable because a gambling company, the gambling profile has changed today. People gamble during a match. They gamble on things that people would never have thought of gambling on before. And so it's impossible to size, basically, on premises. So you have taken the three-tier application, moved it onto VMware Cloud and AWS, so from VMware to VMware, basically. You have not touched the database layer with all the complicated networking interfaces and undocumented scripting. You have not touched the application at all, the application layer, but you have refactored the web layer onto native AWS with EC2 and with auto scaling. So now this application can scale up and scale down with demand in real time. So you have transformed the capability of an existing application, but importantly, for almost zero risk, because VMware is unknown and auto-scaling and EC2 is known, for zero risk, and immediately. So time to market, you've given him basically something immediately rather than years to rewrite an application. So 90% immediately rather than waiting years to potentially have the perfect solution. That is a fantastic use case and really innovative, Ophir. Thank you very much for that. So on to the second area then. So the second aspect of application development. So you are also interested in, you know, containers and Kubernetes and so on. Would you care to share what you are doing in that space?
Yeah, definitely, you are right. We invested a great amount of resources on DevOps practice within TeraSky. We started with performing projects for our customers, building CI/CD pipelines for developers, and we see many opportunities here, even together with VMware. So we are trying to adopt the VMware-based cloud solutions with the full VMware Cloud on AWS, the Tanzu software stack. What we are trying to do is to build like a best practice and DevOps competency that will help our customers to manage, to secure, and to build like a reliable environment which runs Kubernetes on top of them. Ideally, how we see that in the future, we see TeraSky managing Bitnami catalogs to approve open source code releases and to manage a self-service to help developers within the organization to provision environment immediately, especially on test environment, which must work like instantly. We also handling with customers and developing services around cross charging of the resources and helping the tightening the environment behind the developers. So we see ourselves continue and investing in the practice and offering our customers a solution based on Tanzu, VMware Cloud on AWS. We realize that orchestrate all this solution, and obviously Bitnami with the assistance of the catalog and the open source code releases.
Ophir, that's really a really interesting area. So you are going to be creating as a practice, a kind of DevOps platform. The DevOps platform really is designed to take away the frustration that has traditionally existed between developers and IT. Developers, you know, develop and they expect IT to provision some test resource for them. There is always a delay for IT to reschedule this test resource. What you are saying is you will move the workload onto VMware Cloud on AWS, give the developers a self-service interface, let them provision whatever they want for testing. You will manage the cross-charging. You will manage the tidying up of the environment afterwards. You will manage the Bitnami catalog of open source components. You will manage the, you know, Tanzu or the Kubernetes platform going forward. So that's a really, and by eliminating the delays for the developers of test capacity, you will speed up the developers' productivity, basically. So that's directly.
This is the main idea. You know, we are working with many development companies, and when working with developers, their business challenge is time to market. They need to, you know, we see many release every day, and we see a huge demand from the business to release new versions of the applications. We help them with the practice that we built on top of VMware Cloud services. We see how we can make that very short time.
Very good. So thank you, Ophir. Thank you very much for being so open and sharing with us and the rest of the community what practices you've built using VMware's cloud offerings and how you've been able to turn them into revolutionary use cases and value add for clients which could not have been delivered before. So once again, Ophir Abikassis, CEO of TeraSky, thank you very much for your time and for sharing your thoughts with us.
Thank you. It was a pleasure. We'll be right back.